All right. Hello, everybody. Happy Saturday morning. Welcome to Disney's Hollywood Studios. March of the Stormtroopers just went by. We'll follow the crowd down Hollywood Boulevard. It's Saturday morning, and I have a fast pass to see the Voyage of the Little Mermaid here at Disney's Hollywood Studios. Music's a little loud, but that's okay. It's still fun. Rhonda, good morning. Christina and Scott, good morning to you. Jeff says it must be Saturday because Herb is live. That is true. Good morning, Kathy. Hello, Tim Peterson. The official, unofficial marketing manager of the Pen of the Month Club. Shani from Pensacola, hello. All a happy Memorial Day.
Eyes and ears on me. You'd better believe I was on you.
Emily, good morning. Cindy, good morning to you. Thanks for joining.
It will not be easy to crush the resistance, but it will be satisfying. If you pass information to the resistance, you'll be considered a traitor and a target. Over here.
Let's see if we can scoot around.
We'll see you again. Advance.
Tony's a fan of the Stormtrooper March. Me too, actually. It's a lot of fun. All right, nice look down Sunset Boulevard. Elizabeth said the broadcast for the highlight of a week from Jamestown, Pennsylvania. Thank you, Elizabeth. I appreciate that. All right, let's skip by Starring Rolls, now closed. Yeah, we've got the trolley Starbucks next door. Headed over here to the Animation Courtyard and the Voyage of the Little Mermaid. A lot of traffic, given that we've got some stormtrooper activity in the area. Shannon says, thanks for the Disney fix. You are welcome. Jennifer misses the Sorcerer Mickey hat. Yeah, that's a controversial issue. I think if your first visits to the park were with the hat, you miss it. I think if your first visits to the park were without the hat, you don't. Mary just got back. Jody says, thanks for sharing. You're welcome. Happy to do it. All right, little stroll past the Brown Derby. Dicky is a Tower of Terror fan. Lindsay says the studios looks busy. Yeah, I think that it's because we had a lot of traffic there with the stormtroopers going through, so everything got bunched up a little bit. I do think there are going to be a lot of people out today. It's a beautiful day. When I started, it was in the lower 80s. It's going to be in the lower 90s today. It's going to be a warm week in Florida. Let's take a look at the arch leading into the Animation Courtyard. Still has the good old Disney's Hollywood Studios logo. Will soon be replaced with a new logo, emphasizing the Hollywood and de-emphasizing the studios part. All right, this is where we're headed, the Voyage of the Little Mermaid. I have a fast pass, so we'll be going in to check that out in a few minutes. So like the next show is at 10:25, so we have a little bit of time. Chris says Brown Derby equals Flight of Margaritas. Sounds like fun. Shannon has got 33 days to go. Jody says, are they changing the Tower of Terror theme? I don't believe so, at least not in the short term. I know that the Tower of Terror attraction at Disney's California Adventure in Anaheim was switched over to a Guardians of the Galaxy. Not sure that's going to happen here at Hollywood Studios, at least not in the short term. Kim says, makes her feel like she's here. Good. Glad that I can share it with you. So, before we walk in for the Voyage of the Little Mermaid, wanted to give you a little bit of news about what's coming up this week. I will be leaving for California tomorrow, and I'm headed to the media event for the opening of Star Wars Galaxy's Edge at Disneyland Park in California. I'm thrilled to be a part of it. Most of the activity is going to start late on Wednesday and go into Thursday and Friday. So Wednesday during the day, I'll have the opportunity to check out Star Wars Galaxy's Edge. I am thrilled to have the opportunity, but I'm not able to release any information until Wednesday evening at 6 Eastern, 9 Pacific. So starting late Wednesday night, Eastern time, look for videos, look for articles, maybe look for Facebook Lives, so you can check out first views of Star Wars Galaxy's Edge from Disneyland Park. If you haven't done so already, you might want to turn on notifications here on Facebook. There's probably a little button in the upper right-hand corner that says turn on notifications, so Facebook will let you know when I go live. You may also want to head over to YouTube and subscribe to the YouTube channel. So you can go to youtube.com, do a search for World of Walt, and subscribe to the channel. I'll also be doing some posts on Instagram, on Pinterest, wherever you are on social media. I'm going to try to be there sharing my experiences and really my blessing of an opportunity to be one of the first to see see Star Wars Galaxy's Edge. Craig, hello to you from Ocean Springs, Missouri. Kathy says she's excited for me. Marjorie says it's awesome. Thank you very much. I really appreciate it. Lucy says, enjoy the trip to Disneyland. I'm thrilled. My hope is on Sunday, Monday, Tuesday that I'll have an opportunity to do some videos, maybe live, maybe to YouTube. Also, perhaps writing up some articles just about my general Disneyland experience before the opening of Star Wars Galaxy's Edge. It's been many years since I've been out west to the Disney park, so I'm looking forward to that part as well. Brian said, just got back, had a blast. Good to know. Stacy said, good morning from Mississippi. All right, let's head in. Hi.
How long to the show? 2 minutes.
Thank you. All right, we've got some time, 15 minutes, but we'll get a good seat. We'll be able to chat a little bit before everything starts. Holly says, looks beautiful here today. It is a really pretty day. It's going to be a hot week in Florida, maybe a good time to go out to California. Brad asks, my favorite Disney World ride. That's tough. But definitely in the running would be the Tower of Terror. It's got it all. Ah, I can feel some Voyage of the Little Mermaid air conditioning. That's nice. Nathaniel from Jacksonville, good morning to you. Jennifer says, can't wait to go back. Linda says, is the Walt Disney attraction still here? Yeah, I think you're talking about Walt Disney Presents. It used to be Walt Disney One Man's Dream. There still are a lot of exhibits about the life of Walt. The movie that talks about him has typically been swapped out with different previews of coming attractions. I think either is actually a fitting tribute to Walt. We definitely do want to know more about him. But at the same time, I think he would be happy that the company is promoting its products and not necessarily only the man. Suzanne says, loves the broadcast. Thank you. Bridget says she'd like to see more classics like The Lion King and The Fox and the Hound. Kelly is going to be here in just 18 days. Yep, Christina's referring to One Man's Dream, also here at Disney's Hollywood Studios. Chris says we need a fast pass for 400 people. Yeah, don't want to take up the entire auditorium, so we'll share. Stacy from Euclid, Ohio. Todd, good morning to you. Hope your trip this August is a good one. Be prepared for some hot weather. We got a few minutes before we get to the theater, then we'll have a few more before the show begins. Victor, happy Memorial Day weekend to you as well. Teresa, good morning to you. Also got an August trip planned. A lot of people are going to be here in August. Wendy in Minneapolis, 104. Wow, goodness gracious. And hello to you. And it's coming back in December. Holly says, is it super crowded? I think there are going to be plenty of people here today. I think the entrance looked a little more crowded than maybe it really is, just because of the Stormtrooper March and everyone was getting swept off of the streets. Bonnie from Ohio. Grace from rainy Buffalo, New York. Jeff has never been to the Voyage of the Little Mermaid. It has been here for a long, long time. Still a good show. I really enjoy it. It's good for all ages, except maybe really small kids who might be frightened by the humongous Ursula who comes out on stage in a very dark and ominous way. Carla says the staging is cute. Yeah, they really do a nice job. Carol's only got 6 days to go, wow. Before you know it, you're going to be standing right here. Mark from Boston, a Bruins fan. Kristen, good morning to you, says, loved the first pin from the Pin of the Month Club. Thank you very much for signing up. And you're the lucky winner of the prompt for the shameless plug for the Pin of the Month Club. If you want a little bit of Disney fun delivered to your home every month, go over and check out pinofthemonthclub.com. I've already actually done some shopping today for the club. The internet connection seems a little flaky. Hopefully it will hold up. But it doesn't hang on, because I think things will be okay. Sandy, good morning to you. Patricia, hello. 163 days, but that's true. Who's coming? Ryan said, is the Sci-Fi Dine-In Theater still here? Yes, it is. That is a Hollywood Studios classic. Glad to see it's still around. Great theming, fun atmosphere. Cast members have a good time with it. So, yeah, definitely a welcome restaurant here at the studios. Rhonda, good morning to you. Hi, Kevin from Butler, New Jersey. I see Kevin is a top fan. Kevin, thank you for all your comments. Facebook, on its own, without any input from me, makes designations of top fans, usually those folks who are most active in the community. So thank you very much for being a part of it. Randy says, great meeting you today. Thank you, Randy. It was good to meet you as well. Thank you for taking a few minutes out of your vacation. It was nice to stop by and say hi. I hope you have a great day. Amy said, Pin of the Month, how do you join? All you have to do is go to the website pinofthemonthclub.com and you'll be able to sign up there. It's quick and easy. Christine says, is the Muppet 3D theater presentation staying? Great question. I don't think it's going away anytime too soon. I think everything that's closed or brand new for the immediate future at Disney's Hollywood Studios has been announced. However, when Disney did some work on the theater that holds Muppet Vision 3D, I noticed that they made some changes so that it could pretty easily be swapped out. So the sign outside is now a theater sign with exchangeable letters. There are just banners hanging on the outside. So if Disney wanted to swap out Muppet Vision, at least from the exterior signage, I think they've set themselves up to do so. Amy has fast passes ready for Wednesday. Angel says, hope they keep the Muppets. I really do like the fact that the Muppets have a presence in the studios. I don't think it's going to be a focus. I would be surprised if we saw any expansion of the Muppets. But for now, it looks like they might be around for a while. Dan says, thanks for the glimpse of our favorite place on Earth. Thank you. Ella from Sydney, Australia. Hello to you. We got a lot of folks packed into to the entrance area for Voyage of the Little Mermaid. Plenty of little kids. Hopefully we'll be able to get in soon. Show is going to be at 10:25. I'm fairly certain I will be able to broadcast because I've done it in the past. But if Disney tells me not to, I will stop. But I don't think that's going to be a problem. Roger, good morning to you. Mary says, wishes she was here in person. For those of you who can't be here live today, I'm glad that I can share a little bit of Disney fun with you. Rhonda says, looks forward to the pin of the month. Always a fun surprise. Thank you for that, Rhonda. Appreciate you being a member. Glad you're enjoying your subscription. Sharon from Colorado. Missy from Blue Ridge Mountains, Virginia. Sounds like a pretty area. Donnie's going to be here in December. Terry Ann is watching at work. Coming next week. Hope you have a great trip. Allison, good morning to you. If somebody could let me know what time it is, that would be interesting to me. I can't really see the clock on my phone while I'm also doing a broadcast, wondering how close we are to the 10:25 start time of the show. I'm thinking we must be pretty close since we really have quite a big crowd here. Oh, and an announcement.
All right, sailors, when the captain says ahoy there, you say ahoy there back. Ahoy, sailors!
Ahoy!
Welcome, everyone, to the Voyage of the Little Mermaid. My name is McKenna, and I'll be your captain. And right next to me, I have my first mate, Logan. Before we enter the theater, everyone, I have a quick few announcements. To those of you sitting in front of the doors, please make sure you're standing behind the yellow line to ensure that the doors do not hit you. Once the theater doors open, please swim all the way inside to the left side first, filling in every available seat. Please reserve the top two rows for our guests in wheelchairs and their parties. And one final reminder, sailors, for the safety of Ariel and undersea friends, please no flash photography or external video lighting. Once again, please no flash photography or external video lighting. All right, my first mate Logan, do you have a final word?
Welcome to the show.
Round of applause for my first mate, everyone. All right, sailors, let's sail and enjoy the voyage.
Ahoy! Okay, thanks everyone for letting me know what time it is. Looks like we are just 5 minutes away from the presentation. And I heard no flash, so I think we're going to be okay to do the broadcast. Ah, and the doors have opened. Let's head on in. Jeremy says, thanks for the stream. You're welcome. I want to let everybody know that earlier today I did a video, which I will post to YouTube shortly, of the new entrance area for Hollywood Studios. So you can see the new and completed bus pickup and drop-off areas. You can see the continued testing for Skyliners. You can see the new security checkpoint as well as the new tram drop-off area. So if you haven't done so, go over to youtube.com and search for World of Walt. Subscribe there. All right, we're a couple minutes away.
June, we're behind you.
Oh, marvelous.
We've got everything.
Good.
Move up,
Disney.
Oh, no. Yes, move up.
Everybody's getting their seat.
Get Percy on your lap.
Oh, sorry, June.
room.
Did you give him a thumb up? Did you give him a thumb up?
All right, so once the show begins, I will be quiet so I don't disturb everyone around me. We're just a couple minutes away. Diane says it's a favorite. Jackie, today is Goofy's birthday. Wow, that's cool. Murphy says, loves the show but needs an update. It has been here for a good long time, that's for sure. I think it's one of those, if it ain't broke, don't fix it kind of things, but it would be nice to see them upgrade some of the technology. Linda says, thanks for letting us see the show. You are welcome. Glad you got a chance to check it out. Ron says, give Goofy a birthday hug. If I see him, I will do that. Brenda said, what park am I in? This is Disney's Hollywood Studios. I still got a few last minute folks coming through the doors. Looks like it's going to be a pretty full theater. Emily's a fan of the show. Jean, happy Memorial Day to you. Diane shared the post. Thank you very much for doing that. Always appreciate when people share anything on Facebook. It's a great way to get the word out and a good encouragement to me. Thanks also for all those hearts and thumbs up, especially the comments. I love chatting back and forth. It's a lot of fun. Thank you for being a part of this. All right, the theater doors have closed. I think it's about time. Brenda's going to be here on Thursday. Hope you have a great trip. You can see a little bit of smoke streaming in here. Ron said, is the phone going to get ruined by the mist? I sure hope not. Shiny says, can't wait to a Disneyland trip. Thank you. I'm really excited about it, too.
Welcome to Voyage of the Little Mermaid.
Here we go.
Because of the special effects involved in the show, we ask that you please remain seated throughout the entire performance. For the safety of our performers on stage, we also ask that you refrain from using all flash photography. High-speed film or video cameras with no lights are fine, but please, no flash photography. And now, Disney's Hollywood Studios presents Voyage of the Little Mermaid.
is Krieger. In some party else's leg. You dream about going out there, but that is a big mistake. Just look at the world around you, right here on the ocean floor. Such wonderful things around you. What more is you looking for? Under the sea, under the sea. Darling, it's better, glamour, it's better, take it from me. Up on the shore, they work all day. Out in the sun, they slave away. Where we live on the fruit and the floating under the sea. Darling, all the fish is happy, as all through the waves they roll. The fish on the land, they're happy, they sail close to in the bowl. But fish in the bowl is lucky, they eat for a worse of fate. One day when the boss get hungry,
guess who's gone beyond the plate?
What? Oh, under the sea, ha! Under the sea. Nobody beat us, fry us and eat us in Frigga's sea. We want the young folks love to cook, under the sea we off the hook. We got no troubles, life is the better, it's under the sea. Under the sea,
under the sea.
Seems like the sea, yeah, we got the media naturally. Even the sturgeon and the ray, they got the earth and start to play. We got the spirit, you got to hear it under the sea. Ha! The flute play, the flute, the cop play, the harp, the bass play, the bass and bass and the trump, the bass play, the bass, the drum play, the drum, the drum is the duke of soul. The bass, the play, the dings on the strings, the top rocking out the black fish. She sings the smell and the spell, they know where it's at. I know that drum is
cool.
My connection's complete. Wouldn't you think I'm a girl? A girl.
angelfish. The solution to your problem is quite simple. The only way to get what you want is to become human yourself.
Can you do that?
Oh, my dear sweet child, that's what I do. It's what I live for. To help unfortunate merfolk like yourself. Poor souls with no one else to turn to. I'll make a potion that will turn you into a human for 3 days. If he kisses you before sunset on the third day, you'll remain human permanently. But if he doesn't, you turn back into a mermaid and you belong to me. Have we got a deal? That's right. But you'll have your man. Life's full of tough choices, isn't it? Oh, and there is one more thing, sweet cakes. No more talking, singing, zip!
Without my voice? Well, how can...
You'll have your looks, your pretty face. And don't underestimate the importance of body language. Come on, you poor unfortunate soul! You've got to pay the toll. Take a gulp and take a breath and go ahead inside the scroll. Not some jetsam, now I've got the boys. The boss is on a roll. This poor unfortunate soul. A Lucas of Ruga comes of the Caspian Sea. Princess Glossitis and Max Laryngitis, the Vulture to me. Now sing. Keep singing!
Does love him, doesn't she, Sebastian? It's like I always say, Your Majesty. Children got to be free to lead their own lives.
Then I guess there's just one problem left.
And what's that, Your Majesty?
How much I'm going to miss her.
You can talk.
I'm trying to tell you.
You're the one. It was you all the time.
There you have it, Voyage of the Little Mermaid, live from Disney's Hollywood Studios. Hope you enjoyed the show. Thanks as always for tuning in on Saturday mornings, typically around 10. And remember, this next week I will be in California for the grand opening of Star Wars Galaxy's Edge, with coverage starting late on Wednesday the 29th and also on into Thursday the 30th and Friday. I will also going to do my best to do some live broadcasts and or videos from the Disneyland Park and from Disney's California Adventure. I'm especially excited about getting a chance to see Cars Land. So thank you for joining me. To all of those of you who gave me a heart or a thumbs up, thanks for that. I always enjoy the conversation in the comment section. And a number of people said that they shared the video. Thank you for doing that. It's a great encouragement and a good way to get the word out. If you haven't done so, go over to YouTube and search for World of Walt. Subscribe there. I will be posting some exclusive content, including a video I took just earlier today of the new entrance experience for Disney's Hollywood Studios, including the reworked and now open bus terminal, some Skyliner testing that's going on, new security checkpoint area. All that's going to be up on YouTube shortly. So thank you for being here. I hope you have a great Saturday morning and a great weekend. Until next time, God bless.